and then MVP, which is very similar as well. Still have the model layer. And again, think of this not as a class model, but as a model layer. And you can have many, many services, model controllers, interactors, whatever you call it here. Then you have the presenter, usually talks to this layer, get responses here, translate that into data, view model data, usually creates here view data or view model. You know, view models that only holds data. It translates that model data into view data. The same, it will translate date to a string here, for example. So the view can render that data. And it communicates with the view through an interface. And when there's an event, the view usually sends that event to the presenter. And it creates this two-way communication where the view talks to the presenter talks to the view, which can create a return cycle. That's why usually the presenter holds a weak reference to the view in presenters, right?
Yes.
To avoid this return cycle here. There are variations of the MVP pattern as well. Just like there are variations of the MVVM and MVC patterns. For example, you can eliminate this dependency here from the view talking directly to the presenter. And what can happen is the view talks directly to components in the model layer somehow, to some kind of delegation, notification, you know, you compose them, some kind of closure protocol, and the view events will be translated directly to model actions. When the model changes somehow, the presenter will be notified to, again, could be through delegation, callbacks, and so on. And the presenter translates that event into some presentable data to the view, sends it to the view. And then you create this unidirectional flow. And then it creates a unidirectional flow instead of this two-way communication flow. And you avoid that return cycle in here.